In PTC Mathcad, there are built-in functions which you can access from the Functions tab, but you can also create your own user-defined functions, and that's what we'll look at in this video. So first off, if you want to create a function, you're going to type in its name. Let's say I want to make a function to calculate the length of a hypotenuse of a triangle. I'm going to call it HYP. Now for naming the function, it's the same rules as for naming a variable. You can use uppercase or lowercase letters, numbers, underscores, subscripts, Greek letters, and so on. You just can't start it with a number. You can actually even start it with an underscore if you want. And so after you give it your name, you're going to use parentheses and then specify what variables or what values are going to be evaluated in the function. And these do not have to exist beforehand. These are just explaining in the function what operation should take place. And so I'm going to pass two values to it. And then let's use the colon equals, the definition operator, to specify what it is. And I'm going to go back to the math tab. From the operators, let's choose square root. And this is going to be equal to a, and I'm using shift 6 to get 2 squared. Now I'm going to use the space button to select the entire argument, plus b, and then again shift 6 to get to my exponent squared. And that's the definition of my function. So let's go ahead and try it out. Let's say I want to know the hypotenuse, and it's 10 on each side, hit the equal sign, 14.14. Yeah, that sounds right to me. Let's see, let's try one of our special examples. So we know that there is 3 squared and 4 squared, that's equal to 5 squared. And again, just do one more. Another one I happen to know, 12 and 5. For that triangle, the hypotenuse length is 13. You can also use values that take on units. So for example, let's write an equation for force. Force as a function of mass and acceleration is going to be equal to mass times acceleration. That's spelled correctly. And then I click outside, and now we pass some different values in here. Force, and for the mass, let's just start with a value of 25. Then I'm going to put multiply by the unit I want to use. You can go to the units drop down here, and for mass, let's say this is 25 pounds. And then for the acceleration, let's say it's going under an acceleration of 4 g's. I can do 4 times g, and then hit the equal sign, and there evaluates it. Automatically figured out that g was the acceleration due to gravity, and here it's giving me a value of 444 newtons. It's reporting the values in my base set of units. And so let's create just a couple other ones. So for example, let's use Einstein's equation. We're going to do E as a function of m is going to be equal to m times c and then squared. And again, when I click outside, it's automatically going to figure out that, hey, since I didn't previously define c, c must be the speed of light constant. And so let's find e for, let's say, 2,000 pound car. And that's, wow, 8 times 10 to the 19 joules would be released from it. And one last user-defined function, I'm going to use the deflection equation. So let's go to our symbols, and here we could get to our lowercase Greek letter D. Again, you could do the lowercase D on the keyboard immediately followed by Control G, and that'll convert it to the Greek letter. And this is going to take on 4 arguments. And here I'm using E again, and it's smart enough to distinguish that, hey, this is not the function E, this is just the value that's going to be used inside of this function definition. So let's say that that is going to be equal to P times L. I'm using the space bar to highlight both of those, divided by A times E. And now we can try evaluating this. This time I'll use the keyboard D, Control G to get my Greek letter, and then P for the load. Let's do 1,000. And for the units, it's going to be a force unit. Let's use pounds force. And then for the second argument, the length, let's say that this deflection is for a beam that is a length of 10 feet. And I'm just typing in feet directly. Next, for the cross-sectional area, you can mix and match units. So I'm going to say that the cross-sectional area is going to be 25 times, and let's do millimeters squared. And the last argument, let's do a Young's modulus. And I'm going to start out, let's say that this bar is really expensive. It's made out of titanium. 16 times 10 to the 6 times PSI, then hit the equal sign. And here we see that it is reporting it in millimeters. In meters. It looks like a thousandth of a meter. If I delete the unit and then type in inches, there I can see that, okay, it looks like it's deflecting about 2/10 of an inch. And for evaluating this, you can change on these different values. So for example, let's say that I'm going to change the Young's modulus. Let's use a different material. And this time it's going to be for aluminum. So that is 69 times, and I'm going to go to the units, it's gigapascals, and the units for this would be under pressure. There we have it, gigapascals. Click outside, and you can see that the deflection went up about 50%. So that is how you define your own functions in PTC Mathcad. I hope you enjoyed this video. For more information, please visit www.creowindchill.com. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and click the subscribe button to be informed when new videos are uploaded. Thank you very much.